RIP fourth wall.
Okay, everyone. We are done here. We are all done reaching each other's bones, right? I have something to plan for today. If everyone could come sit at the front of the room. Is this about the festival? Well, sort of. Ugh, do we really have to do something for the festival? It's not like we can put up anything good in just a few days. We'll end up just embarrassing ourselves instead of getting any new members. That's a concern of mine as well. Well, I don't really do well with last minute preparations. Don't worry so much. We're going to keep it simple, okay? We won't be needing much more than a few decorations. Sayori has been working on posters and I've designed some pamphlets we can give out during the event. Okay, that's great and all. But that doesn't tell us what we're actually going to be doing for the event. Ah, sorry, I thought I heard it about already. We're going to be performing. Performing? Monika? Yeah, we're going to be having a poetry performance. Each one of us is going to choose a poem to recite during the event. But the cool part is, we're also going to let anyone else come up and recite poems too. Sayori is putting in all the posters in case anyone wants to prepare ahead of time. Sayori, who's been coloring the poster, holds it up for us to see. Aren't you kidding me, Monika? You didn't already start putting those posters up, did you? Well, I did. Do you really think it's that bad of an idea? Well, no. It's not a bad idea. But I didn't sign up for this, you know. There is no way I'm going to be performing in front of a group of people like that. I agree with Natsuki. I could never in my life do something like that. Imagining it, Yuri shakes her head in fear. Guys. No, Sayori. I understand where they're coming from. Remember that Natsuki and Yuri had never said their poems before with anyone until just a couple of days ago. It's a lot to ask for them to recite their poems out loud to a whole room full of people. I guess I kind of overlooked that, so I'm sorry. But I still think we should give it our best. We're the only one responsible for the fate of this club. We start the event and each put on a good performance, then I will inspire others to do the same. And the more people who perform, the better we'll be able to show everyone what Lopsa is all about. Yeah, it's about expressing your feelings, being intimate with yourself, finding new horizons, and having fun. That's right. It's those reasons that we're all in this club today. Don't you want to share that with others? To inspire them to find the same feelings that brought you here in the first place? I know you do. I know we all do. And if it all it takes is standing in front of a room for 2 minutes and reciting a poem, then I know you can do it. Natsuki and Yuri remain silent. Sayori looks worried. I guess that leaves me no choice. I agree. I don't think it's too much to ask. I think that Sayori and Monika have been trying really hard to get new members. Then the least we can do is help them out a little bit. Well, maybe, but it looks like Natsuki doesn't have any arguments left. Okay, fine. I guess I'll just have to get over it. Alright, phew. Thanks, Natsuki. What about you, Yuri? Yuri dejectively glances around at everyone's expected faces. I guess I don't really have a choice. That's everyone! You're the best, Yuri. This club is seriously going to be the death of me. Oh gosh. You'll be fine, Yuri. But anyway, let's move on to the main event. I want each one of you to choose a poem of yours. We are going to practice reciting them in front of each other. No way! Monika! This is too sudden. Well, if you can't recite your poem in front of the club, how do you expect to do it in front of strangers? Oh no. Don't worry. I'll start off to help everyone get feel more comfortable. Can I go next? Of course. Now let's see. Monika flips through her notebook to a specific poem she has in mind for herself. She then stands behind the podium. The title of the poem is The Way They Fly. Monika begins reciting her poem. Her clear, confident voice fills the room. More than that, her reflection is pristine. She knows exactly how to apply emotions behind each line she recites, bringing the words to life. Is this something she's done before, or is she simply a natural? I glance around me. Everyone has their eyes on Monika. Sayori looks amazed. Yuri has an intense expression on her face that I don't understand. Finally, Monika finishes the recitation. The four of us applaud. Monika takes a breath and smiles. That was so good, Monika. Thank you very much. I was just hoping to set a good example. Are you ready to go next, Sayori? I'll go next. Whoa! Yuri's fired up all of a sudden. Yuri glances a sheet of paper between her hands and stands up. Keeping her head down, she walks quietly over to the podium. This poem is called... Yuri anxiously glances at each other. You can do it, Yuri. It is called After Image of the Crimson Eye. Yuri's voice shakes as she starts reading the poem. Just a moment ago, she practically refused to do this. Why is she suddenly putting in so much effort? As Yuri gets past the first couple of lines, her voice changes. It's almost like what happens when Yuri gets absorbed into her books. Her Korean words transform into a shape of syllables of a fierce and confident woman. The poem is full of twists and turns in its structure that she enunciates with perfect timing. This must be a rare glimpse into the whirling fire Yuri keeps concealed inside her head. Suddenly, she finishes. Everyone is stunned. Yuri snaps back into reality and glances around her as she bewildered even herself. It's up to me to save this situation. I'm the first one to start applauding. Everyone joins me afterwards and will give Yuri a recognition she deserves. It's not that we didn't want to applaud her, but we were caught so off guard that we must have forgotten. As we applaud, Yuri holds her point to her chest and rushes back into her seat. Yuri, that was really good. Thank you for sharing. Looks like Yuri is down for the count. Okay, I guess I'm next then. Sayori hops out of chairs and cheerfully walks to the podium. This one is called My Meadow. Sorry, I giggled. Sayori, it's a lot harder than I thought. How did you guys do it so easily? Try not to think of it like you're reciting to other people. Imagine you're reciting it to yourself, like in front of a mirror or in your own head. It's your poem, so it'll come out the best way that way. I see. Okay then. Sayori begins her poem. Somehow it feels like her soft voice was made as a perfect match. The poem isn't aimlessly cheery like Sayori is. It's serene and bittersweet. If I were to read this on paper, I wouldn't probably think much of it. But hearing it come from Sayori's voice almost gives it a whole new meaning. Maybe this is what Sayori meant when she said she likes my poems. It's like I get to reach more deeply into someone I thought I knew thought and true. Sayori finishes and we applaud. I did it. Good job, Sayori. Even Larry liked it. I guess that's a good sign. What does that even mean? It came out nicely, Sayori. The atmosphere of the poem fits you really nicely. But it might that other poems wouldn't work as well with that kind of delivery. I really don't understand. In other words, I've seen poems of yours where that sort of gentle delivery wouldn't work as well. They might need a little more force behind them, depending on what you're reading. Oh, I know what you mean. I've been practicing that kind of thing. Just embarrassing to do it in front of everyone. Then next time I'm going to make you pick a point that challenges you a little more. We don't have much time before the festival, you know. Okay. Now, who's next? Natsuki? Don't make me go before Larry. It's not like I compare to you guys anyway. Might as well get Larry lower expectation standards a little before I have to do it. Natsuki, it's fine. I might as well get it over with. But it's not like I have much of a selection to what to read. I'll just have to go with what I wrote for today. I stand up and step in front of the podium. Everyone has their eyes on me, making me feel terribly awkward. I recite my poem. Since I'm not exactly confident in my own writing, it's hard to put energy into it. Despite that, once I finish, I receive applause anyway. Sorry, I'm really not as good as everyone else. Don't worry about it so much. I think it's less about your abilities and more about your lack of confidence in your writing. That's something that'll improve over time, though. Yeah, maybe. Alright then, that just leaves you, Natsuki. Yeah, I'm going. Natsuki begrudgingly gets out of her seat and makes her way to the podium. The poem is called... Well, why are you looking at me? Because you're presenting. Anyway, the poem is called Jump. Natsuki takes a breath. Once she starts reciting the poem, her sour attitude disappears a little. While she's still a little enthusiastic, her poem has a rhythm and rhyme to it. It's Natsuki's trademark style and it works surprisingly well when spoken aloud. The words feel like they bounce up and down as if giving life to a poem. Natsuki finishes, everyone applauds. She hops back to her seat. That wasn't so bad, was it? Easy for you to say. You better not make me do that again. Ah, well. Do you at least feel prepared enough to recite a poem in front of other people? I mean, doing it in front of other people will be way easier. I can put on whatever face I want for the other people. But when it's just my friends, it's just embarrassing. That's a surprise, Natsuki. I think it would be the other way around for me. Well, that's just how it is, so... Yeah, I guess that in that case, you won't have much to worry about for the festival. That said, I want to thank everyone for coming through. Might be hard, but I hope that you all have an idea of what this is like now. Make sure you pick a poem and get enough practice before the festival, okay? I'll be making pamphlets, so let me know ahead of time what you'll be reciting. Jeez. I should probably find something other poems to recite instead. That's fine too. It doesn't have to be your own. I'm already pleasantly surprised that you're putting in all this effort for the club. It makes me really happy. Yeah, no problem. Okay, everyone. I think that's about it for today. I know the festival is coming up, but let's start write poems for tomorrow as well. It's been working out really nicely so far, so I'd like to continue that. As for the festival, we finish planning tomorrow, and we'll have the weekend prepared. Monday is the big day. I can't wait. I can do this. Alright. I stand up. There's no way I'll be able to find the same enthusiasm as Sayori and Monika, but I'll do my best to get through it. If it's for the sake of the club. And impressing Monika. Then I'll have to do my best. Ready to go, Sayori? Yep. Look at you two always going home together like that. It's kind of adorable, isn't it? Jeez, guys. Don't make such a big deal out of it. It must be a little nice, though. Well, how am I supposed to respond to that? It's okay, Larry. You don't have to say it. Whatever. Let's go already. I walk home with Sayori once more. Even though it's only been a few days, a lot of things have already changed. But today, Sayori is being a little quieter than usually on the way home. Hey, Sayori. Sorry, I was spacing out. Ah, no wonder. I was thinking about something from earlier. I like how we get to... Sayori fumbles with her words. So let's just say that one day Yuri asks to walk home with you. Huh? What would you do? What kind of question is that? You're kind of putting me on the spot here. Well... Okay. What the hell, Sayori? First of all, why would Yuri ask me to walk home with her? Monika, maybe. Natsuki, no. Yuri, definitely no. But if she did... This is a tricky question, actually. Because if she actually asked me to go walk home with her, would it feel right to say no? But also, it kind of doesn't just feel right to leave Sayori for Yuri. No. Nah, I would still go home with Sayori. Just save quick, get the second page out. I would still go with Sayori. Sayori, you really think I would ditch you for Yuri? Huh? But she's so beautiful and smart. Jeez, I already see her in the club every day. Besides, you always seem to really like doing some going home together. I wouldn't just ruin that for you. You're so silly, Larry. You think about me too much sometimes. Yuri would deserve it if she wanted it so. Sayori, I already made up my mind. I really can't figure you out sometimes. Sorry. Besides, what's the point in speculating something that's never going to happen? The conversation trails off. It's kind of weird thing for Sayori to care so much about. But I want to respect her and keep her happy too. Then again, the festival is only a few days away. Who knows what will happen in that time?